Hi friends, today let us take up design of keys. Now, keys are used in shafts. You know, generally shafts are circular. So we have a gear wheel or a pulley, whatever it is. We mount it on the shaft. Now, because this is circular, we make a hole, circular hole in the pulley or the hub of the pulley or the gear, and what happens is when load is acting on it, there will be slipping. That is, if we do not use a key, there will be relative motion between these two parts and the power will not be fully transmitted, or no power will be transmitted in that case, because these both will not be rotating at the same speed and there will be relative motion. If you want that to be, that is not to happen, then we have to use what we call a key. A key prevents relative motion between the shaft and the mounting on the shaft. Like a key, maybe it may be a gear wheel, it may be a pulley, whatever it is, there should be no relative motion between these two parts. Then we have to use a key. In keys, we get different types. Saddle key, tangent key, then we use sunk key, we have feather key, etc. Now, the key design of what we have is design of sunk key. Sunk key means it will be partly in the shaft and partly in the hub of the pulley or gear wheel, whatever it is. It will be half in the shaft and half will be in the hub of that part which is on the shaft. Now, these sunk keys are again of different types. Like we have square sunk key, we have rectangular sunk key, and we have a gib headed sunk key, we have woodruff key, etc. But the one key which generally is asked is a rectangular sunk key. That is, its section will be rectangular. This is called as the width of the key, and this is called as the thickness or depth of the key. So half of it will be in the shaft and half will be in this thing. If both the width and depth are same, then it becomes a square key. Woodruff key will be like this, semicircular in section. It will be like that. Now, the one which is important for us is the rectangular sunk key, because that is the one which is going to be asked to be designed. Now, this rectangular sunk key has three dimensions. It will be, if I draw it pictorially, it will be like this. This is how it is. So this is its length. You can call it as L. So this is its width. Some books give it as B, some books give it as W, whatever it is. This is depth or thickness of the key. So there will be three dimensions. Normally, L is 1.5D or 1.5D plus 13 mm. W is D by 4, WR, it is also called as B. Width will be D by 4 to D plus 13 divided by 4. T or H, it is also called as H. In some books, it will be D by 6 to D plus 13 by 6. Like this, we have so many mm. In all these things, D is the dia of the shaft. So, the dimensions of the key depend upon the dia of the shaft on which we are going to use this. Now, generally in our design data handbook, the width and thickness of the key are available if you know the diameter. There is a table. If you know the dia for a particular dia, what is the width and what is the thickness, we can get it from the table directly. We can get it, the width and thickness. What we don't get here is this L. Now L can be between 1.5D to 1.5D plus 13 mm. These are empirical formulae which we use. Now once a part is designed by this, what we have to do is we have to check for it. Now there are two ways in which a key can fail. A key is like this, it is partly sitting like this, it is subjected to a force like that. The force, tangential force that will be acting on the key will be equal to F will be equal to T by D by 2 or 2T by D. This 2, D by 2, instead of writing D by 2, I can put that 2 here. That will be F, that is the force. And due to this force, the key can shear, can be sheared. So the shear stress, tau, will be equal to 2T divided by D into the area to be sheared is L into B or L into W, whatever it is. It depends upon different design data handbooks use different this thing. This is the shear stress induced in the key, and the crushing stress, it can fail due to crushing. Either this half or this half can fail in crushing. Now that will be equal to 2T by D into L into H by 2, or this can be written as 4T divided by DLH. So many Newton per mm square. So many Newton per mm square. This will give you the stresses induced in the key due to, these are the two ways in which it can fail. One is shear and the other one is this thing. This T is the torque transmitted by the shaft. Same torque is to be used here. D is dia of the shaft, L is length of the key, W is width of the key, and H is depth of the key. So we can substitute these values and check the key whether it is safe or not. Generally, either we have to check the key or we will have to find out the length of the key by using these formulae. We will do a few, one or two problems and keys, and we wind up this unit. I'll take again from the question bank. It's like this. Question number one on keys. Question number one. Recommend the rectangular key for a shaft of 50 mm diameter. Recommend, this is question number one, problem number one on keys. Recommend a, that is select, recommend whatever it is, or design, what they can say anything. Now problem number one, recommend the rectangular key for a shaft of 50 mm dia. Diameter of the shaft on which we have to use the key is 50 mm. The shearing and crushing stresses, tau and crushing stresses for the key material are 42 MPa or 42 Newton per mm square, 42 megapascal. And 70 megapascal, 70 megapascal. So recommend a rectangular key. Now from the design data handbook, go to the design data handbook. Keys are there. Shaft dia up to and including. So this is up to 50 mm. It is, width of key is, width is 16 mm, you can write 16 mm, and thickness is 10 mm, up to and including 50 mm. If it crosses 50 mm, then you have to go for the next size. Now here he is using the symbol for this thing. This is used as W, and the thickness is taken as T. He is using T as the symbol here. Now you have designed it. Now what we will assume is, we will assume that we have to check this. Now length of key L can be, we can take it as 1.5D, that is 1.5 into 50, if you take it is 75 mm. Now assuming the key and shaft are made of same material, you know we have used the formula T is equal to pi d cube by 16 into tau. From this we got that d is equal to 16 t by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3. So from this formula we can get T, assuming that same stress is there for both key and shaft. So pi into d cube, that is 50 cube divided by 16 into tau, is given as 42. So T will be, use the calculator and find out T. T will be pi into 50 to the power of 3 into 42 divided by 16. That will give me 103.0835 Newton millimeter. This I got T. If the dia of the shaft is 50 and 42 this thing, it can transmit a maximum torque of this much. We will check whether this key is safe for this. So tau key, shear stress induced in the key, will be 2 times T max into DLW divided by DLW. So 2 into 103.0835 divided by D is 50, L is 75, into W is 16, that we have taken from the table. These two values we have taken from the design data handbook. Now this is there, into 2 divided by 50 divided by 75 divided by 16 will give me 34.36 Newton per mm square or megapascal. Now this is the permissible value, that is the induced value. The key is subjected to this much stress if it is transmitting this much torque, and if the dia of the shaft is so much, length of the key is so much, thickness of the key is so much, sorry, width of the key is so much, then it is safe because it can take up to 42 Newton per mm square, but we are stressing it up to 34.36 Newton per mm square. Then crushing stress of the key, crushing stress is 4T divided by DLT. So 4 into 1030835 divided by D is 50, L is 75, into T is 10 mm. So let us see, 4 into 1030835 divided by 50 divided by 75 divided by 10 equals 109.95 Newton per mm square. Now here it is more than this, much more than that. So you have to write here, because the crushing stress induced in the key is greater than the permissible crushing stress given in the problem, the design is not safe or key is not safe, that is, there is a chance that it may break. So what you have to do is, you will have to increase this, you will have to increase the length of the this thing. Say, let us say whether we will get it with 100 mm, suppose I take it as 100 mm, 4 × 1030 835 divided by 50 divided by 100 divided by 10. What do I get? I get 82 point something. No, it's not, even now it is not safe. I'll take 125, 4 × 1030 835 divided by 50 divided by 120 divided by 10. 68.7. Now it is safe. So you have to write, because induced shear crushing stress in the key is greater than the permissible value, value, the design of key is not safe. Therefore, the length of key L is readopted once again as 120 mm. Now, the crushing stress in the key will be equal to same formula. Here, instead of 75, you get 120. So, if you make it 120, this will come to how much? 68.7 Newton per mm square. So, now it is safe because it is less than 70 Newton per mm square, it is safe. So you have to do it like that. This is how it is to be done in case it is not safe. Let's take up problem number 5. Now this problem is like this. Select the dimensions of the key so that a shaft 30 mm dia, shaft is 30 mm dia, is transmitting power at a maximum shear stress of 80 megapascal. The shaft is subjected to a maximum shear stress of 80 megapascal. If a pulley is connected to the shaft by means of a key, the stress in the key should not or is not to exceed 50 MPa, 50 megapascal, and length of the key is 4 times its width, 4 times its width. So now, from the design data handbook, first, we'll find out the torque. Torque transmitted by the shaft will be pi d cube by 16 into tau shaft. So, pi into 30 cube by 16 into 80. So, that will give me pi into 30 to the power of 3 into 80 divided by 16, that gives me 424 115 Newton mm. This is the torque transmitted by the shaft. Now the key also has to transmit the same shaft. Now what you do for a shaft of dia 30 mm from the design data handbook, width W is for 30 mm, W is 10 mm, and thickness of key, thickness that is T is equal to 8 mm. Now he says length L is equal to 4 times width, that is 4 into 10, that is 40 mm. Now we have to see whether it is safe or not, only in shear. Now shear stress induced in the key, induced shear stress in the key is 2T divided by DLW, 2T divided by DLW. So 2 into 4 to 4, 115 divided by D is 30, L is 40, W is 10. Into 2 divided by 30 divided by 40 divided by 10 will give me 70.7 Newton per mm square. Now this is not safe, this is more than 50 Newton per mm square. So you have to change the length. Length of the key must be, it is not 40, you can take it as up to 1.5D we can take it. So we will take it as say 70 mm. If I take 70 as the length of the key, 2 into 4 to 4, 115 divided by 30 divided by 70 divided by 10, if I take, now it will be 40 point something. So you can take it as up to 60. No, D is 30, no, 45. 1.5 D means. If you take D as, L as 50, 2 into 4 to 4, 115 divided by 30 divided by 50 divided by 10. 56 it will be. You can take it as 60 mm. Readopt it as 60 mm, 2 into 4 to 4, 115 divided by 30 divided by 60 divided by 10. Now it will be 47 point something. So it will be, you readopt it as 60, 2 into 4 to 114, 4 to 4, 115 divided by 30 into how much? I taken 60 into 10, that will fetch me 47 point something, 47.1 Newton per mm square. Now it is less than 50, this is the permissible stress, 50. So now the design is safe. So the shaft length of the key should be 60 mm. This will finish this problem.